Welcome to another session of Yoga with Dr. Beth. Today, we will be doing another session of Yin Yoga. If you've never done Yin before, please know that we will be holding the poses a little bit longer. Holding poses for about 5 minutes for the active pose and about 3 minutes or so for the rebound pose. Get a little deeper into the tissues, into the body, as we allow the body to relax into the poses just a little bit longer. As always, you respect your body, you take breaks when you need to take breaks, and you modify if you need to modify. A couple of props with me. We will be using 2 blocks. If you do not have blocks, you could always have big books or some sort of item that gives you a shape like this. So laying it flat like this will be level 1 or lowest level. On standing it up on the longest side, we'll bring it to level 2 or height 2, the second highest level. And standing it on the shortest side, we'll bring it to level 3 or the highest level. We'll give you suggestions on what level to place your blocks at, but again, you can modify based on your body. I also have handy a small bolster. If you do not have a small bolster, you could use a towel or a blanket and roll it up so it's sort of in this shape, long and skinny around it. And then lastly, I have my big bolster with me as well. And again, if you do not have a big bolster, please utilize maybe pillows, whatever you might have in the house that will give you a nice rectangular shape with a nice cushion on the side as well. So you want to find the one that will work for you. We'll begin by taking a meditation. Using the blocks, you might use 1 or 2 depending on how high your blocks are. Some blocks are thicker than others. These are pretty thin. We'll be coming into an easy sitting pose, which is where the legs are crossed. You can cross whichever leg in front is most comfortable for you. To add height, place the block underneath your hips. And again, you can add 1 or 2 blocks depending on what makes you sit the most comfortable. We're crossing, in this case, my left leg in front of my right, and you will find a comfortable position. Taking a mudra by bringing the pointer finger to the thumb, making an O with your hands, dropping the mat on the knees, pulling the belly in, dropping the shoulders down. Begin to close your eyes. We'll slowly begin to breathe in and out through the nose. Begin to focus the attention on the breath. Noticing the air as it travels in and out through the nose. Begin to draw your attention inward. Begin to relax through the shoulders. Take the tongue off the roof of the mouth and the jaw. Begin to invite some stillness into this moment. Quieting the mind, quieting the body, breathing. Consider setting an intention for your practice. Relax the forehead, the jaw, the shoulders. Focusing only on the breath in and out through the nose. Take a deep breath in. Sigh it out. Releasing the fingers. Maybe wiggling them. Uncross the legs. Shift forward and remove the block. Gently bring the legs around. Going long ways on your mat, open up your feet. Nice and wide. Bringing both blocks in front of you, kind of like Stonehenge. I am going on the second height. Feel free to go to the highest height if that makes it easier for you. And then place your large bolster on top. Flex the feet back. Forearms on the bolster. Take an inhale. And as you exhale, begin to lay out on the bolster. Maybe letting the forehead drop. Maybe turning the head to one side. Find that comfortable spot.
Relax through the pelvis, let it melt into the mat. Relax through the shoulders. Allow the chest to fall into the holster. Your head turned to one side. You gently just pick the head up and turn it to the other side. Gently begin to bring some movement into the body. Begin to rise up a little. Relax through the shoulders. Take the bolster and place it off to the side.
Using two blocks, place them, framing the foot so you can square yourself to the body. You can have them on the second height. You can have them on the lowest height. It's truly your choice. Maybe even a higher height. Square yourself to the leg. Inhale. And as you exhale, start to slide the hands up. And the shoulders square. Pulling the belly in nice and tight. And those hips on the mat, try not to let that right hip pop up on you. Breathe. If you would like to make this a little bit more comfortable, I invite you to grab your bolster. And of course, place your bolster across the leg, laying out over. Depends on what you are looking for from your practice. Breathe.
taking that breath and sending it to the low back hip area on that right side. Deep breath in. Sigh it out. Gently begin to come up a little. And turning that outside block onto its highest height. Feel free to keep that bolster where it is, or you can remove it. And roll the right shoulder back. Then lift the right arm up. So you try to stack the shoulders a little. Reaching the right fingertips to the top of the left hand. Breathing. The shoulder blades down the back. Take the tongue off the roof of the mouth. Feeling the opening and extension to the right side of the body. Roll the right shoulder back a little bit more. Breathe. Deep breath in, sigh it out, relax the right arm down, bringing yourself up, take a moment to settle, move the bolster out of the way, but if you used it on this side, keep it handy, you'll want to keep it even. Grabbing both of your blocks. Frame that right leg. Again, using whatever height you did on the other side, square yourself to the right leg, belly tight. Begin to bring the arms out. Framing the foot, squaring the shoulders, hanging the head. Keeping that left hip on that mat, breathing, relaxing through the shoulders, and if you added that bolster in between, make sure you do the same thing on this side, providing a little bit of space here as you bring your head. The shoulder blades down the back, pull the belly tight around that left hip, hang your head. Jaw, the shoulders, so that left hip stays grounded.
So much magnificence. Here's the ocean. Waves are coming in. Waves
are coming in. Take a deep breath in. Sigh it out. Come up a little bit. With that back block, turn it on the highest position. right hand is on the block, start to stack the shoulders, and you can use the bolster to extend the left arm overhead, maybe reaching for that right hand. Try to let the arm rest. And maybe you notice you're not as open on this side. So roll the left shoulder back, hollow out the belly. Breathe. And breathe into the left side of the body. And in that extension along the left side. Breath in and out. Release. Moving the blocks out of the way. Moving the bolster. Bringing the legs around the front for a moment. Just placing the feet flat. Hands behind you, simply take a couple of little windshield wipers here. Beginning to move into our next position. Moving into mermaid legs, bringing the right leg behind you so the left leg is in front, essentially making triangles with both legs, getting those hips as even as you can on the floor, grabbing your blocks, placing them in front of you, and simply beginning to move forward. And you want to make the adjustments here, bringing the forearms to the blocks, relaxing the shoulders, allowing the head to hang, breathing. Hollowing out the belly, trying to get a little deeper into the pelvis. relaxing the muscles of the face. Maybe revisit that intention you set at the beginning of class. Relax through your jaw. Deep breath in through the nose. Sigh it out. Begin to slowly come up.
Bringing the back leg, the right leg, across the body. Crossing it over. And then just simply taking a nice little twist towards the knee. Looking back over the shoulder. Breathing. begin to unwind the feet.
Hands behind you for support. Place both feet flat. Gently windshield wiper. Transition to the other side, bringing the right leg in front,
the left leg behind you for those mermaid legs. Again, we're making a diamond shape, a triangle shape with the right leg and the left leg as it comes out behind you. Try to get your hips nice and level. Inhale. Blocks in front of you, and exhale, bring the forearms to the block. Find a space, curl the hips, hollow out the belly, shoulders down the back, spine long, hang the head, breathe. Relax the jaw, drop the shoulders down the back, relax the muscles of the face, breathe. Stem to the spine. Lengthen to the back.
a deep breath in. Open the mouth, sigh it out. Begin to invite some movement, bringing yourself up. This time the back leg, the left leg will come up front, crossing over the right leg, sitting up tall as we twist towards the knee, looking over the right shoulder, breathe, extend through the spine. Placing the hands behind you, feet flat. We'll begin to windshield wiper those knees again. Nice and easy. Moving the legs to one side. Begin to move the blocks out of the way for a moment. We'll reach for the small bolster or French fry, like my daughter likes to call it, placing it on the mat crosswise. So if you're using a rolled up towel, you'll want to roll it up. When we lay back, we're going to be trying to get it across our upper back area. And you might need to make some adjustments here so that you're in the best position for your body. Begin to turn around. Bringing your big bolster, slide it under your knees. So the legs will be supported by the larger bolster. Beginning to lay out over. This small bolster or towel. I like my head to rest on the mat. Now, if your head doesn't rest on the mat, you can feel free to place a block underneath there, and that will help with that. And then we want to find that sweet spot with the shoulders.
Maybe rolling the shoulders under a few times. Each side, find that perfect spot. The arms are out in cactus arms. The chest is lifted. Shoulders roll down the back. Chin is off the chest. Maybe you need to make an adjustment with that bottom bolster so the legs are fully supported. And we close the eyes. Simply relax through the forehead, the jaw. Take the tongue off the roof of the mouth. Allow the shoulders to melt into that bolster. Allow the legs to get heavy. Close the eyes. Breathe in and out through the nose. No work, no effort. Deep breath in. Sigh it out. Shavasana. begin to wiggle your fingers and toes. Start to invite some movement back into the body. Start to bring your awareness back into your room or space. Extend your arms overhead, extend the legs out long beneath you. Get a nice deep stretch. Begin to roll to one side, maybe moving the bolsters out of the way. Using the bicep as a pillow here for just a moment. Gently brush yourself up to a seated position. Whatever is comfortable for you. On an inhale, the arms sweep up overhead. Exhale the hands back down. Again, inhale the arms sweep up. The palms press as you float your hands to the heart space. I hope you enjoyed your practices with me. It is truly my honor and privilege to guide you through classes. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste.